Hey guys, it's Rock the Golem, and welcome to Unforgiving, a Northern Hymn. Now, like all the indie games I've been playing every Sunday, I found this one on itch.io, and it really caught my interest. It's another one of those survival horror type games where you run around in first person and everything, but this one actually has you interacting with creatures and lore and mythos based in Swedish culture. Now, I don't know anything about that, so everything I'm going to see is going to be incredibly new to me, I imagine at least. I have no idea if I even know what stories are Swedish in origin or where they may have come from. I'm not sure about that type of stuff. So everything I feel like I'm going to encounter here is going to be something different. At least that's what I'm hoping for. Now, mind you, this game is also a pre-alpha release demo. Actually, it's in alpha. It's a pre-release. It is on Steam to be greenlit as well. I don't think it's gotten approved for greenlighting just yet, but it is up there. So if you guys enjoy this playthrough, I suggest going to that page, which I'll actually link in the description, and going to support this game. The cool thing about this is that the guys that created this game are actually the five lead developers from Notes of Obsession, which is a game I played a while ago on the channel that I also found on itch, which actually was suggested by my friend Taylor. So if I hadn't have played that, I probably would never have known about this game and never really have been that interested in it. Although, who knows, just the idea of these like Swedish horror stories coming to life might have been enough to entice me to want to play. But anyway, let's see what Angry Demon Studios has brought us. But first, let's go through real quick. Your only source of light is a box of matches. Now, I don't know how long the matches last for, if they burn more when you run faster, or anything like that. If there's a limited number of them, can you get more? Who knows? But there's a couple different modes. We have Start Game Stories. I assume Stories lets you go and pick and choose. So let's start up the game and see what happens. The controls seem to be pretty rudimentary. So can't breathe. That's never a good sign. Ooh. Running through the woods, it sounds like. Oh, no, drowning in the water. Jeez. Now, I sound like a very young individual in this game. Potentially a girl. I can't really tell, though. But it sounds like, you know, swimming for my life. Now I'm hearing my heartbeat. Well, they say you can survive 3 minutes without air. Oh, but look, I'm fine. I'm here on the shores of Sweden, apparently. I believe it was a girl. Nice kicks, by the way. Ooh, I was in the water. Well, I mean, I knew I was in the water, but I was in like a raging river over there. Yes, I am a female from the looks of it. I'm very, very emaciated based on my arm. Must find help. Well, my cell phone's not working. Do I have matches yet? No, I do not. Okay, so movement, crouching, and sprinting with shift. Ooh. Now I have the brightness turned up all the way in the game itself. In the options, I turned it up pretty much all the way, because like, oh, you know, it was one of those sliders where, you know, turn it up until you can see like this icon, but just barely. So I did that, but in doing so I had to put the brightness up almost all the way. Ooh. That was a buzzing in my ear. Is that a beehive then? Is that what you are? Maybe you're just a rock. I can't tell. I did hear a buzzing, though. A very loud, obvious buzzing. That's just my own footprints. Okay. My footsteps, rather. But this game already looks very dark, which understandably so. I'm supposed to be using, you know, matches and the light to light my way. It's a very pretty sky. Those are clouds rolling through, though. I was hoping it'd be like, you know, fire for a house or something. Lighting, that's light on the tree. That maybe something was coming, or something was over that way. Yeah, jump? I can jump, but that's not going to help me get over this obstacle. Which, these may be here very purposefully. Can't get over those. Alright, we got it. Okay, it sounded almost like fireworks going off in, like, rapid succession. I don't know what that was. Not doing too good about jumping over this stuff. Jump doesn't seem to be too helpful. I feel like in real life I would be able to climb over that stuff very easily. And it's getting very much darker. I can't see a damn thing in that direction. Alright, we'll navigate by the stars. I have no idea how to do that. I do to an extent. I did read a wiki how one time about how to navigate by the stars. I know there are different methods if you're on the northern hemisphere as opposed to the southern hemisphere. I am on the northern, and of course, I don't remember how to do it anymore. I'm sorry? What was that? Oh, God. Well, I think I see light off in that direction. So that's the direction I'm going to try to head in if I can get over this barrier that's in my way. But I do see light. I saw light. Okay. That was creepy, though. I have no idea who just spoke to me. And I don't think I'm going to like it when I find out who it was. And that's all there is to that. All right. Yes, we have light. We have fire. I believe you are fire. Look what I have found. I have found fire. I have not made it. I have just found it. Press E to interact. Okay. E to pick up matches. All right. Well, we got a whole box of them, so it should be a decent amount. But I have a candle. Why don't I just take the candle? Left button to light the match. Which apparently takes a fair amount of time. That's a very bright match. Right button to drop the match. All right, you know what? Just for the sake of this tutorial, I will do... Huh. Can I get more matches in here? Will they magically appear? No, they will not. Okay. Well, I found my light source, so that's good. It only took me, what? I've been recording for 8.5 minutes, so probably about 5 minutes or so. Yay, let there be light. So I gotta find help, but I have no idea what direction I should head in for help. Hello. Oh, looks like you might be a candle over there. Hello, railroad tracks. Not used in quite some time. I think I'll follow you right over... Oh, nope, there is a candle. And it is lit. Huh. Now I wish I knew my Swedish lore a little bit better. Hello, random stuffed doll of... I thought you were a giraffe, but probably not. Bit of a little bit of blood there on your haunch. There's a check mark on the ground. What is that supposed to mean? Can I let you on fire? Is that what I'm supposed to do? Nope, that didn't work. Okay. So I have the candle. And I have this doll. I literally can do nothing with this that I can tell. So what do I do? I also am very confused. I opened this up, but it hasn't had me do anything. Again, there's this check mark here on the floor, on the ground, rather. But what am I supposed to do? All right. I'm pretty sure this is a giraffe, or supposed to be a giraffe. Just weird looking. Yeah. Not that it's really going to help me now, but if anyone can tell me what this was supposed to be symbolic of, I would greatly appreciate it. All right, railroad tracks, where do you go? All right, let's follow the tracks, because obviously this was one point in time would, like, have gone to some sort of civilization, or at least crossed paths with civilization at some point. So I feel like following these tracks might be my best bet. You know what? We can run. Let's run. See if this makes my match go out any faster. Oh, good. The railroad tracks lead right to a lake. Huh. Oop. Looks like there were birds in those trees. Light another match real quick. There are birds. Am I going to lose my match if I go in the water? I can't go in the water. Maybe if I go down this way? No. Oh, wait. Hold on. Come on. All right, so I officially cannot go in the water, which means the railroad tracks have led me astray. What if I lit the forest on fire? Would that do anything? Would that help me, Pinecone? Can you help me? Guess not. Okay. Huh. Well, there's the lantern I just came from. So let's run up to that real quick. Giraffe, I still don't know what you're used for, sir. That's a wall. I guess we'll head back the way we came, but not along the tracks. Ooh, I think I see another lantern. I don't want to move unless I have light with me, and I also don't know if running the way I was is actually making my matches go out faster. Oh wait, there are the tracks. So yes, this is the lantern I just came from. This is actually where I got my matches, I believe. Alright, so let's continue to run out and away from the matches and the tracks. See if this leads me anywhere. I'm not even sure how I really came across those freaking lantern in the first place. I was amazed I had made it that far. Alright, well, I probably won't be able to get back up that way. I feel like I've got to, I feel like this is almost like a Slenderman type thing, where I have to, go through the forest and find all of those candles and the lanterns and open them up. Again, I wish I knew my Swedish lore a little bit better, because I have no clue what I'm doing. I'm about to drop the match, too. So, I mean, I do have the option of dropping the match early myself, but at the same time, I'm just going to drop them on my own anyway, it seems. I know I say this quite often with these indie games, because most of them don't really say, go here or push here, stupid or anything. Oh, I hear running water. But, I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh, I'm back to the raging river that I pulled myself out of. How did I end up here in the first place? I have no idea. I don't believe this is where I began, but this is where I am currently. No clue where it is I'm going. Start lighting the forest on fire, see if that helps me figure something out. People will find me then, I bet. This very well may actually be where I started. I'm not even entirely sure anymore. How I would have looped around like that, I don't know, but somehow I feel like I've managed to do it. Alright, ooh, here we go. We've got some... Oh, that's just more, fog. I thought it might have been... Can I do anything with you? Can I light you on fire? Nope. No, I cannot. I was kind of hoping that the clouds and the... Oh, hello. You look like one I haven't come across yet. Yes, yes, you are. Ooh, I just heard a squeak. Oh, there's many lanterns over here. I guess I have... Ooh, a cabin. Random cabin in the woods in the... Oh! Oh god, what happened? What is... Space to jump? You want me to jump in the river? Left shift to sprint and jump. Okay. Alright, you ready for this? Ready for this to go horribly? I am. Okay. Can't go back that way. Give me light. Maybe... I have to jump back over this thing, I guess? Okay, that's what it was. Well... That was, I was hoping that would be, my salvation, but apparently it didn't work out that way. Come on, let me... No, I can't. There's no way I can jump that, is there? No, probably not. Alright then, back into the woods I go. I did go along the river there for a little bit. So I'm gonna hug this wall and keep it to my left, see where that takes me. Keep my eyes out for any other light boxes with candles in it. Get some high ground over here, see if it gives me a better view. Nope, nothing. I hear some creaking, and now I have some animal noises. Ooh. Ooh, hello, light. I am hearing, metallic squeaks, though. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. I think this is not one I have not been to yet. Come on. Nope, this is one I've been to. Although, no, wait. This is... Wait. I came to this one, I think. But... It didn't... The window was... Ooh, okay. I wouldn't have closed the box, though. You said I don't remember closing the box, and now I don't know. Is the map changing on me, or am I really just this bad with remembering what direction I've traveled in? You know, my buddy John and I go hiking in the woods, or we used to go hiking in the woods a lot. We haven't recently, because, I mean, it's been winter, but also we've been busy with other things, but he was definitely much better with cardinal direction than I was. I was definitely more of a... Well, that didn't sound good. Just heard sound like a tree was going to fall on me. I was definitely more of a beaten path type of hiking individual, and I didn't like to stray from the path or like go. Oh, the music just kicked up. I don't like that. Why did it kick up? What's happening? Or what's going to happen, rather? He always used to like to go off trail and like find like his own path, like, you know, almost find like natural paths that maybe animals would have created. And I will say, the few times that we did do that, we actually encountered quite a number of deer. So that was kind of cool. There was actually one time we were hiking along, and we had just come off of a natural path and onto the regular path again. And we got so... Whoa. I hear, like, beating drums. Oh, God. What's happening? What is going on? I'm keeping my back to this stone wall. What? Oh God. Protect me, light. Oh, what is happening? No. Whatever it is, I don't want it. Ooh, there's light over there. Gonna make a break for it. I don't care. Ooh, there's a cave. And the railroad tracks. You know what? I don't care. I gotta go in. Something's gonna kill me, but... Oh, you know what? I'm about to lose my damn match. Going back over to the light, and then lighting another match. Come on. There we go. Seriously, I need a sandwich. Look at that hand. That's just a withered, emaciated hand. These tracks are, like, all over the place. The walls are also kind of spreading out, too, so... Oh, this looks so safe. This just looks like the safest tunnel I've ever been in. Look at it. I mean, I guess there's no reason to not feel safe about it. Because, you know, it just leads me to a dead end here. Oh, okay, not a dead end. I just have to crouch and... go through all this. Because, yeah. Going through a tunnel that's already caved itself in partially is really a good idea. Oh, God. I will say this, John and I never went through one of these things. If he ever suggested it, I'd probably smack him. Because no way in heel. Hello, bag of... Oh, so that wasn't a check mark that I saw. That was one of these coins. Like, almost look like glyphs, kind of. Come on, let me relight a match here. See, I thought it was a check mark next to that giraffe, but like, as you can see, like they're like, they look like runes almost. Of course, I can't do any, and more blood. Great. Why does everything have to have blood on it? Oh, that was pleasant. Looked like a freaking Titan from Attack on Titan, just my size. Wherever it went, it's... I could hear the freaking, like, joints crackle. Oh, it's gonna rate me, isn't it? It's gonna go freaking re-dead on me from Zelda and just hump me from behind until I die, isn't it? Oh, look, blood. And the glasses. More blood, more glasses. Yes. Yes, this is exactly what I wanted. Adventure. What's that sound? I gotta toss this and light another match. I don't want it. Oh, I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. Don't want it. Don't need it. You can take it back, return it, exchange it, something. Just, this is not for me. Not for me. Oh, oh, that's a shadow. That wasn't even a titan. That was a freaking shadow. I hope you guys saw that, because either that or I'm starting to hallucinate. And that only happened with Fatal Frame. I don't want it to happen with another game. DV no likey. I must be like you, Rock. I must be Rock. Rock the Golem and be like you. Brother Rock. Must be stoic. Must be strong and steady and solid. Things between you and me. You and me game. Not so solid. People know you cross Rock. They must know business is still good. Well, okay. Things are kind of quiet now. I'm about to lose my match again, though. I swear to God, I'm going to light a match. There's going to be something in front of me, and I'm going to crap myself. Nope. Okay, good. Thank God I did not bring a change of underwear. I can't see the walls anymore. No more walls, no more rocks. Gonna run. Oh, music, why? Music, why, music? Oh. I still had a perfectly... Light a match. Don't do it. Oh, what was that? Oh, screw you, lady. Oh, she bit me. How nice. And I'm back. All right, sorry about that, guys. Unfortunately, I had a phone call that I had to take right in the middle of me, you know, crapping myself with that attack. Come on, match. There we go. That seems to have taken longer. All right, so I just got maliciously attacked by, well, like I called her a titan at first, but whatever the hell she was. I have a nice bite mark on my arm now, too, so that's interesting. And we're still stuck in this cavern. Why I chose to go in here? I don't know. I feel like I should have taken my luck more with the river. Was that what we... I believe so. Was that what we looked like? I believe so, brother. Now, where was that caption when I needed it out in the woods? Those look like people. There's arms. I see, like, a belly, a rib cage, chest. This actually kind of reminds me of the trees from Salad Fingers when, like, he goes out into the woods and, oh, God. Oh, they have faces. Oh, jeez. Match. Damn it. Oh God, what's with my hand? Oh, I'm holding the, am I holding the matches or? Okay, yeah, so let me light a match real quick. So this reminds me of, there was an episode of Salad Fingers where he goes out and he sees a tree and the tree has, oh God, what happened to my arm? That's from the bite? Holy shit. Hold Q to check arm. What am I doing? But he goes out and he sees a tree and it has like a face and body parts and stuff. And am I following a map? What's going on? That's weird. Oh, there. Am I turning into a tree? Like that person got bit in the chest. So that's what happening to me. That's what is happening to me now. Jesus. That makes a lot of sense now. Okay. But, like, he talks to the tree and everything, and the tree is like, it's cold out here, Daddy. Please let me in. Like, it's not fair. It hurts. And Salad Fingers is like, nope, nope. You have to, like, learn your lesson or whatever it is. And, I mean, Salad Fingers was very creepy to begin with, but that just, like, brought it to a whole other level. His fault. He who lived here. He who let them in. He who started everything. Really? You don't say. Well... I'm glad to know that it's his fault and not mine. Oh, there are many of these trees. I'm going to become one of them, aren't I? Ooh, this one looks like he was actually taking aim at something. Like he was holding a rifle. Interesting. All of them have, like, weeping blood tears. So, I don't know if that's just, like, part of the transformation, what it is. But this is just very, very unpleasant. I won't hurt your mother. I promise. Just leave me alone. Oh, no, it's a kid. Oh, you poor thing. Dear God. Angry Demon Studios, you twisted bastards. What have you done? I mean, I know it's based on, you know, Swedish lore and everything, but that poor child. Poor me. You're gonna turn me into one of them, aren't you? God damn it. I think I just heard whispers of, I'll be okay. And then, like, I'm still hearing it. Oh, God. Oh. I don't wanna. Dear God, I don't wanna. Hush, my baby. Oh, God. Oh, that is a baby. I thought she was holding, like, coconuts or something at first. Oh, dear God, no. Sorry. There's no way I can squeeze through that. Hold. Oh, no. Please don't. Oh, I'm a terrible person. And the Pacific Rim sound in the background. Oh, God. So, they weren't just the tree. They were, like, in the tree. Good God. Well, I just wasted a match. Not that it really matters, but... Oh, wow. But, I mean, obviously I'm hearing voices and everything, but was that actually... Like, did I just kill a mother and her baby? Oh, wow. Well, I made it through. Took me a while to shimmy through that, huh? Can't tell if I'm heading back out in the... Nope, there's no stars. I'm gonna run a little bit. Just to speed things up. I don't want to miss any details, though. Okay, I'm back out in the woods. Do I follow the tracks? I feel like following the tracks should be the thing to do. I feel like that's going to be my guide. Like, I thought that was the case before. What was that? I hear these random noises, and I have no clue what the frick they are. Huh. This is pleasant. I'm gonna lose my match in a minute. Speed it up a bit. Again, I have no clue if these tracks are supposed to be, like, the guide I'm supposed to follow or not, but... Oh, what are you? I'm not going anywhere near you, sir. That's right, you keep walking. You just walk away. I'm going nowhere near you. Or maybe I am, because the tracks are looping around in your general direction. Jesus Christ. Ooh, is that a light box over there? I thought I saw one. That might have just been like a graphical error, but... No, I don't think I saw one. Or maybe I did. Oh! Ooh, it's the cabin! Am I on the other side? Alright, the box is here. I can't open it, and I can't light it, but... Holy shit, I made it to the cabin. Was not expecting that. Hello, people. Friendly people, I hope. Renee Svensson and Heinrich Anderson. Or Henrik. Hey! That, you know what? I made a joke about this before. This is actually an IKEA toy. I don't remember the name of it, but this actually... is something that IKEA sells. That's kind of cool. Oh, we have some letters here, too. Rune Svensson. There's the address. Can't open it, but okay. I could bring in your mail, folks, if you really want me to. Thought I saw something move, too, when I picked up the horse. Or when I went to light the match as I was picking up the horse, but... What do we have here? A mother murders son, blames it on music box. Great. More of this. Newly found trails of Andrea's possessions found in river. Letter again. Okay. Bottle. What's this one? Same thing. And the bottle? Just a bottle. This one as well? Yep. So this is a happy town. Oh, I'm in the way of the door. I apologize. I heard coughing. Oh, look, IKEA sells those candles, too. Sacrificial rituals of the old days. Oh, I'm in a happy house. Help protect me, horse. Good God. Is that Tiny Tim? No. No, it's not. It's like some ritual stick or something. Swedish beasts. Probably should read that. Rune, I can't take this anymore. Take care of them. Care of who and what, rather? Dirty glass? Guys should really wash your plates and dishes. Mushroom with a wedge cut out of it. Most popular travel locations for a spontaneous trip. And more mail. All right. Well, we have matches. May as well use them. See the creepy boy on the stairs here. Oh, I got a nice little reflection of my match. Uh-oh. Whoa! Sorry, Svenrik. Heinrich. Henriksen. Whatever your name is. Oh, that's the big fat thing, isn't it? Not gonna like this, am I? Oh, this is pleasant. How about a match? Because that flickering is gonna drive me nuts. Oh! Goody. He just ripped the house apart. Well, hopefully he ate him head first. How's my arm looking? No different, really. Gee, I wonder where I'm supposed to go. I would say we should stay... Lightning. I would say we should stay in the safety of the house, but as you can clearly see, the house is not all that safe. The last time lightning flashed, I saw that giant monster. And now lightning is flashing. I'm going to encounter the giant monster again, aren't I? I'm also going down a very obvious path. Which leads me to believe I am screwed. Me no likey. Me no likey one bit. You know what? I'm not going to use matches. I'm not going to let him find me. I will let the lightning help me find him first. That is my strategy for survival. Probably not the best, but that's all I got. Don't stop to help the screaming victim. I'm moving closer toward the screams anyway. Alright, the world is starting to get a little brighter. And a little rainier. There's much flashing now. Shit, I just got myself turned around, I think. Oh, boy. Can you imagine playing this game with a VR helmet? It's gotta be terrifying. Ugh. Lightning. I don't like what you're doing. It's raining. I don't like this either. I'm gonna get all soggy. Oh, boy. Can I have one of those person trees back, please, to kind of point me in the right direction? And what the hell were those people doing living in that cabin, like, so randomly in the woods? Like, horrible, horrible placement. Ugh. I'm just walking along to my death now, aren't I? I feel like I have to light a match. I hear eating sounds. Where is it? And now drumming. Ooh, I see it. I see it right there. Shit. Gotta run. Oh god, it's right behind me. Deke through the trees. Deke through the trees. He can't catch me. He will not have this tender, young female flesh. There's barely any meat on me anyway. Oh god. Hello, person. Person with a fiddle. Grendel? Is that you? Well, he is missing an arm. And now the fiddler's gone. Oh god, was that Grendel? Now I really want to know. I almost kind of wanted to get caught by him now. I didn't, but I do now. Alright, so Angry Demon Studios, thank you for playing. If you want to play the full game, please support us by voting and sharing on our Greenlight Steam, yada yada, things you probably already read when I didn't have a chance to. So, once again, as I said before, I really wish I had more knowledge of Swedish lore. I feel like that creature might have been Grendel, in which case I do have knowledge of Beowulf. So that is pretty cool, the fact that that was thrown in there especially. But I hope you guys enjoyed this game, because I really did too. Like, this is one of the few ones where I actually felt like my nerves starting to kick up a little bit, so that's a good sign that this is going to be a good game. I plan on supporting this on Greenlight. I hope you guys too, because I am really looking forward to the full finished version of this game. Actually, stories. Let's take a look at this real quick. Oh, okay, so this actually gives you some information on the creatures. Huh. Including, like, the lanterns and everything, and no, apparently that was not Grendel. Alright, well, I'm gonna flip through these myself. Obviously you guys will see it in the video. I'm not gonna put it up for you guys to read, because I want to encourage you guys to check out this game for yourself, to learn some of the lore yourself, and hopefully my playing through this will have given you that encouragement to go out and do that for yourselves. So, thank you all very much for watching. If you like what you've seen and heard, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And having said all that, I will see you all on the other side. Take care.